Welcome to Business Innovators Radio, featuring industry influencers and trendsetters sharing proven strategies to help you build a better life right now.
Well, hello and welcome to this episode of our show. This is Mike Saunders with Marketing Huddle. Today we have with us Yolanda Tucker with Tucker Contract Consulting. Welcome to the program, Yolanda.
Hi, Mike. Thank you for having me.
Hey, you're welcome. So let's get started with learning about yourself and your business. How long have you been with your contract consulting firm, and how did you get started in that industry niche?
Well, I started Tucker Contract Consulting in 2013, so I've been right about 2.5-3 years. And prior to that, I have 25 years of experience as a contract administrator for several Fortune 500 transportation companies. And it just became apparent to me that a lot of small businesses did not have a legal resource to help them with the RFP process or the contracting process. And a lot of times I was issuing corrective action plans to those small businesses because they didn't really understand the procurement process and how the contract process worked and their performance metrics and KPIs and things like that. And I said to myself, you know, I think I could be of service to small businesses. So I've been doing it on the kind of on the side for about 1.5 years, and my son graduated from college and got his first full-time permanent job, and I said, you know, if not now, when?
Yep.
And I kind of jumped out into the water to do this.
That's really cool, and it confirms the I guess theory, you would say, but you hear a lot of people say, what should an entrepreneur consider when starting a business? And they say, find a need, find a problem, find a gap in the market, and then provide a solution. And what a perfect way to find that need is working in it day in and day out, and you are the ones processing paperwork going, oh, here's another company that didn't do it right, and you're having to help them within the confines of that firm. But now you're thinking, what if I can go and help them on the front end, which might make them get better contracts, more contracts, or at least smooth out the process? So my question with that would be, Is your service mainly you're helping to smooth out the rough patches, or would your service be you can help get them in front of opportunities to do an RFP?
Well, I do a little of both. I can help smooth out rough patches if they've already, gotten the RFP or contract. I also help. Usually my clients bring the RFPs to me. I don't necessarily look for them. Sometimes some across my desk and I will say, you know, hey, this will be perfect for you. Look at this. But most times they bring the RFP to me because, you know, usually when you get an RFP, and especially if it's a federal one, it's pretty huge and people are intimidated by it. They don't know what to do with it. So they usually come to me with the RFP or with the contract that they want. Or sometimes I will, you know, develop a contract from scratch. It's just according to what the need of the customer is.
Well, here's a question for you. I have consulted for a few years ago for the Small Business Development Centers, and so we would work with some local there are organizations. I don't know whether you've heard of them, but they do something similar to what you do. So I'm familiar enough with the process, and I know that it's an unbelievably untapped opportunity for small businesses to get in front of potential business. And once you learn how to navigate, it can be just a massive benefit for that business. So my question is, how much help do you give a business to even recognize that these opportunities are out there? Do you help them get integrated in with all the many databases so that they can be found and get these RFPs coming their way? And then once they get one landed in their lap, now you'll help them, of course, navigate through that process. But what is your service on the front end?
Well, on the front end, I facilitate training for small businesses to open their eyes to the procurement opportunities that are available to them, because some of them aren't aware that, you know, there are procurement opportunities that are available that they can get contracts with, you know, some of the larger companies or federal or state, you know, agencies. So I definitely facilitate it's called Ready, Set, Procure. And so I facilitate Ready, Set, Procure to let people know, hey, this is an arena that you may not be aware of that's open to you. I do help them get registered with the databases. And like you say, once they are registered and something comes over that they think they're qualified for, they're interested in, then we'll sit down together and go through it and see if they can actually perform the duties that are being required of that RFP or of that contract. And then if they want me to, I'll go ahead and prepare a RFP response or negotiate a contract or, you know, according to, you know, because all procurement lines of all procurement, you know, it's different. It starts some people start with a contract and they, you know, they just want a contract. Some do an RFP. Some just say, hey, I know somebody that can do this. So it's kind of just where you are and how the opportunity comes to that business owner.
Yeah, exactly. And, you know, from my dealings, I remember there were some really unique opportunities that came out. In other words, I think that sometimes people think, oh, well, you get some of these contract opportunities with federal and state, you know, you got to be a big contractor or a big trucking firm or a big construction contractor. But I remember there was two really unique ones that really stick in my mind. So I'm going to mention them and then I'm going to ask you what's some really unique ones that you've seen, because I think there's a lot of small businesses that would take advantage of this if they knew, well, you know, what? I'm not a big, you know, road contractor or whatever, but I can do this. And this one was this one company in Colorado. They trained alpacas, like llamas, and they got a contract. Why? Because the government wanted to train military to use llamas when they went over to Afghanistan. And who would have thought some person running an alpaca farm would get a government contract? And then there was another smaller one where this bakery that bakes muffins, they got a large contract because some governmental agency had a big convention and you had to use a federally procurement, you know, company, and they got that. So there are a couple that I think are unique. Have you run across unique ones like that that could kind of open up the eyes of a listener to say, hey, maybe check on it for me?
I definitely run into some unique ones like that. I am a participant in a program here and a facilitator with a program here in Jacksonville called Jack's Bridges. And so we have one of my colleagues in that program. She bakes rum cakes. And so she has the opportunity to take her rum cakes into the airport authority and be a vendor in the airport. So most people were like, rum cakes in the airport?
Yeah.
How does that work? So I've seen a lot of different opportunities. I haven't seen the llama. That one is very interesting.
Yeah.
But that's one of the things that I want to educate small business owners about, is that there are opportunities pretty much no matter what it is that you do, there are opportunities out there for contracting and procuring for your type of business service, you know, or offering.
Yep. And doesn't that really, really narrow your competitors out there? Because, yeah, you're not the only one that's going to get that request for a proposal, but your competitor down the street or your online competitor, they might not even know about this opportunity at all. And now you're competing against maybe a handful rather than hundreds.
Absolutely. And I'm glad you brought up competition, because sometimes, you know, and that was one of the things that we had to overcome in Jack's Bridges, is that, you know, some people are like, I don't want to, you know, talk to my competition. I don't want to know what they're doing. But in sometimes you have to collaborate with a competitor. You know, I've had big contracts, and we talked about, you said this a little earlier, where you might be a small business and you may not qualify by yourself, but you may be able to collaborate with the competitor.
Yeah.
And, you know, you guys go in together and you guys can get the business together. And in the instance like that, I always tell, you know, the two organizations that are partnering to ensure that you have, you know, the definition of what you're doing in a clearly written contract, so that when the proceeds come back and it's time to split the money and, you know, and be responsible for the portions of the job that your company is responsible for, every party knows, you know, exactly what they're responsible for and when they have to have it done and that type of stuff. But I've done that before. I've definitely, even as a contract administrator in corporate America, where I had, you know, several companies that had to come together in order to be able to bid on, you know, on a particular RFP.
Yeah, exactly. You know, aligning with a strategic alliance is really important. I think there's massive opportunity there. So can you speak to another aspect that I know that you can probably talk for hours on, but let's talk for minutes, because it's something that I think a lot of business owners don't realize with this type of opportunity. It's your status as a business owner. So for, I think it's called set-asides, but if you're a minority, like if you are, let's say, an American Indian, if you are, you know, Hispanic, if you're a woman, if you are whatever the case is, if you have those classifications, you could even leapfrog over other people in the database, because the governmental contracts many times require these contracts to be given to some of these type of people. And if maybe you are a minority and you hadn't checked the box, and you're missing out on opportunity. So can you speak to that? And I've even heard of people that go, you know what, my wife and I are co-owner of the business, and I'm going to make her 51% because now all of a sudden that's women-owned business. So can you speak to that aspect?
Absolutely. And I was definitely going to bring that up before we got off the phone, because I'm an African-American female. So my company, you know, sometimes could get a set aside because of that. You know, there are times that a lot of people don't understand that just because of those, you know, implications there, that they can, you know, like you say, jump ahead of other people and be considered more for the contracts. I don't know what it is there in Colorado, but here in Florida, there's different ways to certify yourself. Sometimes you could do a self-certification, and then there are other times you have to go through a certifying organization in order to be certified. And we have the North Florida Minority Supplier Development Council. I believe it's, that is nationwide. It's a nationwide, but they have, ours is central North Florida, because it does central of the state and in the north part of the state, and then the south has their own. That's the fee for that application. And application is kind of intensive, so I also help small business owners complete the application so that they can get certified the first time and they don't have to continue to go back and try to get, you know, get the certification.
That's, you know, I think that if you were to lay out, and probably in one of your workshops, you lay all of this out, and I think that someone would walk out of that workshop just dumbfounded going, this opportunity is unbelievable that not many people, not many business owners know about. And I'm sure that there are some businesses that just, you know, hey, because of what you do, it's probably not going to be much opportunity, but for the vast majority of businesses out there, I'll bet you could really find some potential, maybe not 20 contracts a minute, but maybe you're going to pick up something, and it's something where you get some momentum and you pick one up here, and then maybe it takes you 2 months to get the next one, maybe the next time 1 month, maybe the next time, hey, I'm starting to get some of these. And I would like to connect up the set-asides concept with your strategic alliance that you mentioned, because you could get with some of these larger maybe not a true competitor, but someone that's similar to what you do, and maybe they don't qualify for some of these set-asides, but you do, and maybe if you approach them and partnered with them, that might make you guys win the contract easier, because now all of a sudden, checkbox for some set-asides, and that company would have never gotten it, and now you guys can share the work, and they're doing their portion, and you're doing your portion.
Absolutely. And I also educate small business owners to understand that maybe you can't complete the RFP for, you know, that bid. But when the bid is awarded, most times those companies that are awarded the bid or awarded the contract, they're going to need subcontractors. So if you're new in business, you know, you could become a subcontractor with your qualifications are usually a little less demanding to be a subcontractor, and then you build yourself up to become, you know, that company that actually goes after the prime contract. So that can happen as well.
Yeah, I think you just got to get immersed in the system and figure it out and get one under your belt and then do it again. And then all of a sudden now it's there's a company that I'm familiar with that's just now all they do. And they're a construction firm, but boy, they just stay plugged into that system and they don't need to go out and do you know, whatever, search engine optimization online, because that's where they focus on. So I'm sure we could talk for probably days on end, but let's give some listeners a way to learn more about what you do and what's some of the best ways they can contact you to learn more about this opportunity.
Well, they can go to my website, which is www.tuckercontractconsulting.com, and they can always contact me directly at 904-534-0589.
Super. Well, Yolanda, thank you so much for explaining some of these opportunities to us. It was great to get to know you and your services.
Thank you for having me. I really appreciate the opportunity.
Thanks for listening to Business Innovators Radio. To hear all episodes featuring leading industry influencers and trendsetters, visit us online at businessinnovatorsradio.com today.